So, good morning to everyone. So, my name is Dr. Anand, the professor of EC department. At this time, I'm going to take the subject name called electromagnetic fields and waves. So, in electromagnetic fields and waves, what is the motivation behind the electromagnetic fields and wave topic is that we have to design three parts in the, after getting this knowledge of this paper, we'll get three parts. One is waveguide. Another one is antenna. Another one is transmission line. So these three components we have to design by ourselves. For that we need some basic idea of electric field and magnetic field and combination of electromagnetic field also. So this, if you want to get the idea about electric field and magnetic field and the combination of electromagnetic field, then only we can design waveguide, antenna and transmission line. So to concrete the idea of what is electric field and what is magnetic field, that is the main motivation behind to study electromagnetic fields and waves. So in this lecture I am going to explain what is Gauss law and what is its application and where it is applied. Those kind of things we are going to discuss in this lecture. Okay. So first of all, Gauss law. So Gauss law So what is Gauss law is that, before going to Gauss law, what is the application of Gauss law? That we must know very well. So the Gauss law is used to investigate D, electric flux density D and electric field intensity E of any irregular close to surface. This is the first application of Gauss law, because if you want to know what is the electric flux density and what is electric field intensity for the particular closed space region, this Gauss law is applied. Second one is boundary condition. Boundary condition. What is boundary condition is that? Again, this boundary condition is inspecting whether the electric field and electric field density is continuous or discontinuous when the two different type of materials are attached together. For example, I have two different materials which has different permittivity, epsilon r and epsilon r1. This is epsilon r2. So if I connect these two materials together, I want to know if it is under the electric field. If the electric field, the E and G's are there, electric field and electric field density, intensity also. So whether this electric field intensity is continuous to this, whatever this epsilon R1, R2, same here epsilon R1. So that we have to inspect. And moreover, what is the nature of electric flux density in this epsilon R1 and epsilon R2, whether it is continuous or discontinuous. Continuous means same D is passing over there, or different electric flux density is passing over there. That kind of analysis we can do by boundary condition. For that we need Gauss law. So the two important point in the Gauss law is that we can find any irregular or closed surface, calculation of D and E, and in boundary condition inspecting what is electric intensity, what is electric flux density, whether it is continuous or discontinuous. Continuous or discontinuous of E vector and B. So this is the application of Gauss law. Now come to the point. What is that Gauss law definition? I mean, what is Gauss law? So Gauss law is that. What is Gauss law defined that the total electric flux, that is psi, the letter, this symbol is called psi, This is a Greek letter. The electric flux in any closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed by the surface. So this is the exact definition of Gauss law. What this is the wording of Gauss law. We can explain with the equation. What is that? Electric flux, the sign is equal to the charge enclosed. This is the whatever the word is there, that is compressed into the one equation. That is psi, the electric flux density, is equal to the charge enclosed. Enclosed means enclosed by the surface. This is the definition of Gauss law. Already we discussed what is application, and now the definition. Then how the Gauss law is derived is means, I'm going to take here as like we are taking one Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. This is called Gaussian surface. What is Gaussian surface? Is it first? It should enclose. It should enclose. The second one is the Q of the enclosed surface area is uniform. Suppose if I have Q, the values of Q, it should not, for example, here maybe cloud density, here low density. That kind of thing is not there. Gaussian surface means the surface which contains the charge carriers is uniformly distributed. That is one kind of lemma for Gaussian surface. So it should be enclosed, it should be. Then one, if any sample surface, if you take any sample surface here, is compatible with the normal component of the sample space. So this is that if you take any point here, P, this is the sample space we are taking, surface area. Then this is a D, the flux density, and this is the AM, which is the normal component. So this is the normal. If you draw any line, this becomes 90 degree normal component, and the angle is making here theta. So this is called Gaussian surface. So if you want to investigate any electric flux density or electric field intensity, we must use this Gaussian surface. The Gaussian surface properties are, it should be enclosed with the, it is enclosed, or it should be, the Q is uniform, and it's the component which is there in this is called normal component. So these are the main point before going to derive the Gaussian function, Gauss law in our case. Okay, so if you choose here, we have come from the derivation now, the mathematical expression. The mathematical expressions, how can we define that means? So any ds, that means differential surface, can be represented in vector. We can represent ds into an vector. So an is nothing but what? The normal component which is along with this one. This is ds, ds is an vector. And what is d psi? As per our definition, the change of flux is equal to the density, what we have, the density d and ds. So d and ds is the combination. What is d here? D means flux density. D can be, we already know that it should be the normal component. So we can represent d into an vector. D is the magnitude, an is the vector. So d vector, it is the flux density of the function, is flux density with the normal component along with them. So we can represent the d an as d into cos theta. in this part. So if you take this is the D, right? If you want to make D, it should be the adjacent side of this triangle. So this is the adjacent side, therefore we can write D cos theta. So we substitute here in this D side, it will become D, DS and cos theta. How it looks like? It looks like a dot product. We know that A dot B is equal to AB cos theta, right? So it looks like dot product. So I can write D side is B vector with the dot product of DS. This is the main point what we derive right now. So D side, the change of flux density, the change of flux is equal to the flux density with the dot product of change of the surface material. So this is the complete idea of the psi. It's not finished. So still we are going to derive that. So I can do. So this one here, d psi only we are taking finished. So d psi is equal to the dot product of d and ds vector. If you want to solve, we need integrate on both sides. So psi is equal to integral, that means closed integral. This represents closed integral on surface d dot ds vector. So here, so psi is equal to d dot ds vector. This is the concept. So this is the exact thing. And as per the Gauss law, we say that the psi is equal to q enclosed here, right? So here we can write q enclosed, which is Q enclosed. So Q enclosed is that it is a closed surface, means for example this one on surface, this one on surface, this one on surface. If you close the surface, what will get? Will get volume. If you close all the surface, what we will get? For example, this is our one cube we have, right? So how many surfaces is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, top and bottom. So 6 surfaces are together. This is called closed surface. The 6 surfaces are together is called what? Volume. So we can write here, so integral d dot ds is equal to the volume integral of rho v and dv. So what is rho v? So q can be classified 3 times, one is rho l, rho v and rho s. So rho l is a line distributed charge, rho v is a volume distributed charge, and rho s is the surface distributed charge. Because it is a closed surface, we need rho v and dv. So this is that, what is that exactly? So integral d dot ds is equal to the volume integral of rho v. This is the exact point of Gauss law. But we want to make this Gauss law into Maxwell equations. We need one more thing. We must know one thing, that is called divergence. So what is divergence? Divergence means we are converting closed surface A vector dot ds vector is equal to the divergence of volume integral. This is called divergence. So we can convert closed dot d dot ds vector is equal to volume integral of del dot d into d. So we can map this one and this one. So what we'll get? We'll get the volume integral of del dot d to d is equal to volume integral of rho d. Both are volume integral. So we are equating the terms. So it's called del dot. So this is called Maxwell's first equation. This is called Maxwell's first equation. This equation is give us the divergence of this vector, of the divergence of electric flux density is equal to the volume charge of the medium. Means, for example, if you take this is as my Gaussian surface. In this case, I have so many cubes here. So it will emit so many flux density in all directions.
So this is the D bar, this is the Q.